Hello everybody and welcome to today's Sunday sermon, which is on the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Today is huge, with a big challenge from Jesus. To deny ourselves is the road to heaven, really. We must deny ourselves and take up our crosses and follow him. In so doing, we gain new life. Now, we have a very dramatic scene in the gospel today, and it's something that's kind of disturbing. Peter is very upset. Why? Because Jesus has just explained to him and the disciples, the apostles, that he is on his way to Jerusalem. And in Jerusalem, he will be handed over to the authorities, who will hand him over to be crucified. Peter spoke out of love, you know. Poor Peter was very impetuous. He would say his mind very quickly, and he'd do things very quickly without really thinking. And here he's so upset because he loves Jesus, and Jesus loves him. But why did Jesus call him Satan? The reason was, it was a throwback to the temptations in the desert. If you remember, the devil came to Jesus while he was fasting and praying in the desert for 40 days, 40 nights. And he tempted him at his weakest moment, when he was hungry and tired. And he said, "You see those stones? You're God. You can make them into bread." See, the devil is clever. He wasn't denying that Jesus could do that, that he is God. But he says, "Do that. You know, you're hungry. Make that into bread." The other temptation was to do miracles, fly off a cliff, and the angels in heaven will look after you. And then, of course, the last effort was, "Bow down before me and worship me." Now, Jesus was reminded of those temptations because that was the temptation not to be God, not to be Jesus, not to be human, but to be a miracle worker and to become a superstar. And you know, poor old Peter kept all that going right up to the end, and he followed Jesus in his last hours, and he was there, and then he denied him three times. Why was he there at all? He was waiting for Jesus to burst out those doors where he was captured and show the world, "I am God. Look at me, what I can do." That wasn't why Jesus came. He didn't come to show that he was God. He was to show us. His purpose was to show us how to live by submitting ourselves to the Father, embracing our crosses, and in so doing, we find new life. Anything that's of any value, we know, without any religion whatsoever, you have to work hard to get it. You know, songwriters spend hours and hours writing and rewriting. People writing books rewrite and edit and rewrite and tear up pages. You can imagine what goes on. And it's all hard work. It's a hard graft. This is life. We know that without speaking about any form of religion at all, that anything that's of value and worthwhile, you must sacrifice yourself to gain it. Don't make any of those things, even the greatest things we do, the kindness that we do, the hard work we do to keep our family alive, to keep bread and butter and inshima on the table, the effort that's put into that, he's not making nothing of that at all. But it's when we take those earthly things and they become ends in themselves. That's where he's talking. And to gain eternal life, we must deny ourselves, take up our crosses, and follow Jesus. Now, what did Jesus do? Now, look at it. He gripped his cross willingly. He accepted right up to the point of death. Yes, he had those moments of doubt, yes. But he completed that calling. He accepted his cross. It's kind of symbolic of all our crosses. He gripped it and carried it on his shoulders. Yes, Simon and Cyrene helped him. But he was on his way and nothing was going to stop him. Now, why was he doing it? He was showing that the only way our lives can have meaning is for us to accept what life throws at us. Not to seek for it, but to accept. We all have different roads to travel. And if we embrace the sufferings that we encounter on the way and willingly do so, in a very strange way, we find new life. He or she who has a reason for doing something will put up with almost anything to achieve it. Now, the greatest secret that I'm going to tell you is what you know already, but maybe you don't appreciate how good you are, all of you. I am always enthralled, and I'm sure you are, at how people accept their crosses, huge crosses. And I say to myself, oh my God, I couldn't do that. If that happened to me, and you can think of umpteen examples around the world today, people living in war zones, earthquakes, in ghettos, poverty, what people do and what you are doing with your life. I think all of us are doing it almost automatically without much decision making. And that's not a bad thing. It might sound like we are zombies obeying something without working it out and without really believing in it. No. All of you looking at me here today have lived your life so far. And you can all look back on days that weren't great and times that weren't great. How did you survive? How did you get through all that? You did what Jesus is talking about today. You embraced the troubles. Why did you do that? You may not believe this, but I think because you are holy and because all of you have a sense of God in you, without really realizing it. You probably say, oh, that's only for priests and nuns and to be holy and to be prayerful and all that. But oh my God, you're the guys who put it all into practice more than we do. Although I shouldn't look and say I have it easier than other people. We all have our challenges and difficulties in life. But we are doing it automatically. Through prayer, believe it or not, any little prayer you do, that sense of God that you have, the good that you do, the way you look after your family, the way you work hard every day on the farm or in the workplace, whatever job you are doing it and you are giving it there, you are sacrificing yourself for the good of your family or for the good of other people. And lots of people who maybe don't have a family, are not married, that's good too, because you too You have faced life and you have life today because of something you have inside you, that sense of resignation to the will of God. I think we do it automatically. It's like when you practice your faith, like practice anything, for football or golf. You know, they speak about muscle memory. Because of constant movement of the arms, and when you are swinging a club, a golf club, if you keep at it often enough, you will automatically do it, hurling the same way. You know, great players make great scores automatically, instinctively, because they've been practicing. Likewise with our faith. We've been challenged slowly along. We've got some bit of religion in us. We've got that sense of God, more than we give ourselves credit for. So, please, don't feel that it's beyond you today. You are doing those things. You are embracing your crosses. You are denying yourself to keep everything going in your family. Now, what Jesus is saying today, take up your cross, follow me, follow him. And in the sense that he always had his eyes on eternal salvation, things that last forever. Doing things that would, the kindness, loving, charitable works, praying even for other people, all the things that we do that are of a godly nature, forgiving each other in relationships, in marriages, at workplaces, on the football field when somebody makes a mistake or somebody gives us a belt and we say, oh, and you know, we don't hold it in for life. We just get on with life and we forgive one another. And we say, that's par for the course. That's the fortunes of war. We take the knocks. We get up and move on. So today we are learning to be appreciative of the sense of self-denial we have. This is what I would like to say to you today. Be appreciative of what you have already. You are doing the right thing. You are denying yourselves. And you are doing the right thing. Keep it up. Embrace your crosses. And trust in the Lord. Trust in God. So may God bless you. I would like to end with a quote from a song which you may have heard of. And it says, love isn't love until it's given away. May God bless you. Have a beautiful day and a lovely week ahead, and keep safe. May God protect us from this coronavirus. And we pray for a vaccine and that we'll be relieved of it soon. Bye for now.